National Social Services are pleading for the federal government to extend disaster payment plans, lifting incomes to $600 a week. Joining me live now is Australia's Council of Social Services CEO, Cassandra Goldie. Cass, good morning to you. So, new report has come out today. What do you find is the reality for those who are living in lockdown?
Well, in this report, people who are in lockdown right now in the Greater Sydney area are reporting to us over half of them have lost paid work as a result of the lockdown, and about half of them are currently very worried they're going to lose their housing. I mean, overall, what across Greater Sydney and Victoria and South Australia, we've got over a million people who were relying on some kind of social security when lockdowns hit, and they are currently excluded from accessing the disaster payment. So we've got this gaping hole and a two-tier system, Peter, which means that people who were on social security are now going back to just $315 per week if you're on JobSeeker, and for younger people it's just $256 per week. Now, find me a rental property that is affordable on that amount of money. I mean, it's distressing to read these stories. People, for example, saying they've got $40 a week left once they've paid their rent. They are completely locked out from getting any paid work, aren't they? And many people have already lost paid work. And these are people on the lowest incomes with the least behind them. And many of the areas hit by the harshest lockdowns in Greater Sydney are, of course, communities where there are very high numbers of people who were on the very lowest incomes and who desperately need this financial assistance today.
So what more is needed?
Well, we're saying let's extend those disaster payments to everybody who has been hit by the lockdowns. People on Social Security need to be included so that we're providing an income floor for people. So people who have the least have at least $600 per week to cover their rent, to pay for the three meals a day, to cover the medications. That's come through big as well, Peter. People are going without medications, the choices between food and the medications they need. And of course, this is a public health issue, isn't it? We're saying to people, please stay at home. Don't go out and work when you shouldn't be going out to work. Yet we've locked down over a million people who are living in deep poverty now on these, far too low social security payments, whereas their colleagues alongside them, who probably are in a better financial position, not great, but they're getting $600 per week. And so it's a two-tier system that's just plain wrong. Yeah. We didn't do it last year. The government did, of course, include people on social security in the economic supports available for all the right reasons.
And how long would you hope that that would last for?
Well, we need to fix it urgently. They can use the disaster payment system. The Prime Minister can go into National Cabinet this morning, get those arrangements in place and announce it this afternoon and make sure we're backdating for people. And then when Federal Parliament comes back, Peter, we've got to fix the adequacy of Social Security. This is the problem that is, in everybody's face. When people say, I can't live on $600 per week, imagine trying to live on $315 per week. And it hurts and it's a disaster whenever you lose your job. So let's get into Parliament as soon as it returns and fix these Social Security payments so they're adequate for lockdowns, because we're not out of this yet. We know that the economic shocks are real. And if you don't have a job, if you've lost paid work, you need just enough so you can stay at home. You're not going to at least lose your housing or your rental properties. Let's remember, Pete, a lot of those rents have gone up. They haven't gone down over the last 12 months.